So hello everyone, welcome to the official YouTube channel of ISBR Business School and welcome to the another video series of video series Expert Matters. Today we have Ashish Vardhan among us. Welcome Ashish, we are so glad to have you.
Thank you for having me.
Let me just start by giving his introduction. Ashish is a financial services professional with over 10 years of experience in commodities, derivatives, multi-asset class broking. He works for one of the world's largest non-bank clearing firms, EDNF Man Group. He also has experience in startup ecosystem from building and heading a commodities broking house desk to his own mobile application startup called Receipttree. So Ashish, would you like to share your experience with all the upcoming generation management student across the globe?
Yeah, so thank you for inviting me for this call. So I'll give you a quick gist of what I've done so far since my 14 years in UK. I came here to do my MBA at the peak of the market 2006, late 2006. Right after I completed my MBA, end of the term Lehman Brothers happened, which pretty much changed the entire scenario globally in terms of job world. Pretty much everything has changed since. That has brought in the struggle that comes in into the job market, especially for MBA spectrum, which is a very wide spectrum. So you're jack of all trades, but you're not master of any particular sphere. So it becomes very tricky to get into a role specific job. And which is what I realized right after my MBA, when there was a carte blanche recruitment freeze across UK. And the need was for much more specific subject matter experts rather than somebody on a wide spectrum expertise. So what I've learned over the years is the market has shaped towards somebody who has a very funnel exposure to one discipline rather than a wide array of expertise. It does help you knowing bits of everything, but then your subject matter where you are working should be deep enough for you to have that exponential growth that you look for. I have built my career around financial services. So I started my career with a retail banking group called HBOS Limited. Again, when I joined, it was going through a turmoil and it got taken over by Lloyds Banking Group and became one of the largest retail banks within UK. So from retail banking, I then moved into more institutional broking services. Where I worked with a company called Sapien Capital Limited, again, an FCA regulated London entity, where we were offering all asset classes, right from equities to cleared futures and options to FX products, OTC products. So it was a very wide spectrum product offering that helped me specialize into that role and get the most out of what the opportunity was provided to me. One key thing that I learned during this process is your depth of knowledge helps you more than your educational background. Education just helps you to a certain level, but your physical hands-on experience helps you take you to the next stage. And which is what happened with me for 4.5 years with a smaller broking firm, heading a desk, gathering tons of experience, which is very natural for a startup. I was able to join EDNF in 2016, which is one of the world's largest non-bank clearing firms. There I have grown deeper into the market that I offer. So Southeast Asia is the market that I cover. And I was able to build on it because of the fact that I had that basic front office, middle office, back office, clearing, client services experience that aids me to deliver better the products and services that I deal in with the larger market, which would not have been possible had I not had that experience. So to sum it up, yes, that's the key for any person today. You should have a wide spectrum knowledge. That's true. So whatever the field you're in, you need to know a larger knowledge base, but have a specialty of your own so that you get your own, your own niche into your team.
Yes, absolutely. I agree with you because only books cannot teach you everything. You need to have experience to cover it up. You need to have experience to like excel in your career. So Ashish, why would someone choose a management professional? Or let me just put it this way. Why did you choose to be a financial professional? What was there in this profession which inspired you a lot?
To me, that was the only job I could get. No, that's not true. Actually, my role, regardless of the sphere I'm in, so whether it was retail banking to institutional broking, I had always been attracted towards interaction with clients, interaction with new people. And this is very important for anybody who is a pass out today, is to know that one key thing that drives you. It could be, like in my case, interaction with people. It could be numbers. It could be art. It could be design. It could be anything. But that one key thing you should base your future aspirations on is what you like the most. For me, was dealing with people, offering products and services. So per se, you could say in a sales role would be the ideal space for me, and which is where I believe most of the success lies, is if you can hone this experience and this interest of yours and deliver and imbibe that discipline into you. So retail banking, I was dealing with retail clients. Then when I'm into institutional, I'm dealing with institutional, high net worth, ultra high net worth clients. So regardless of whatever the product offering I had in hand, the one key thing that was driving for me was human interaction with existing or new people, that client relationship and client servicing.
Yes, exactly. So there should be one thing that should motivate you to excel in your career. There should be one inspiration or one motivation, self-motivation should be there.
Yes, without which you would not do justice to the role, because you always, because eventually after you work for a while, there is a level of monotony that comes in from the role. You cannot have a role which is going to give you new challenges every single day. There would still be some level of monotony that would come in. And that's where your personal interest will help you overlook that monotony and keep yourself motivated. Otherwise, it's very easy to lose motivation, especially in today's market. The world has changed completely. So you have to have that one single motivation point in conjunction to what you're doing around it to do justice to what you're doing.
Absolutely. I completely and definitely agree with you. Whatever you say, it is absolutely, I agree on it. So, okay, so we all know finance job always keeps you on your toes to consistently expand your knowledge and reach heights in your career. And it is challenging as well. According to you, what are the career opportunities in the financial sector for now, for upcoming generation?
No, it's a very large area. So you've got sectors like banking. Within banking, you've got your retail, institutional, you've got your investment banking space. In my space, where we are into the broking or clearing firms, you've got roles like front office staff, you've got the risk teams, compliance teams, back office teams. Then you've got the consultancy part of it, where specialists who have tons of experience, tons of years of hands-on exposure, and are smart enough to then drive businesses and show them the strategy forward. So that's the consultancy aspect. Now that I've said that, I believe that the two key aspects which I see today that would need, that has a need for tomorrow, and you always should be looking for what is the need for tomorrow. In today's scenario, companies have lost a lot of money, markets have changed, structures have changed.
Exactly.
Your strategy has to change accordingly to place yourself into the market, to be able to stay into business for the next 5, 7, 10, 20 years time. Consultancy could be something that would have a very good driving space for the next 5 to 7 years, where you can, as fresh MBAs, could offer ideas or strategies that would help companies sustain in the near and far future. So I would believe on from my personal, this is my personal opinion, I believe if I was to say 1, 2, and 3, I would say consultancy comes on top today. And this I'm talking from a larger business perspective. From a medium to small perspective, there is lots of opportunities within the startup ecosystem. COVID has brought in challenges and has brought in opportunities, which is why we see a big startup uptick. Startup ecosystem has a lot of need for fresh mindset. New MBAs or new graduates come in with that fresh mindset, what is happening in today's business world, and they are able to contribute better as opposed to somebody who's been into the industry for 10 years would have a set mindset, whereas new guys would have a new zeal and a new ideology that they can, which is, I would say, is a fresh outlook to today's market. And are able to drive that business better. So the first would be consultancy, specific strategic consultancies. Second would be on the startup ecosystem. And the third would be your general, whatever is out there in the market in terms of trading. Lots of people have been trading into the financial market. So the trading is another aspect where there's been a significant growth. You've got your normal retail banking space, which has growth, but again, the payment, the remunerations are not as high as compared to the first two.
Exactly. After listening to you, I can definitely, and I can say that I can feel whoever chooses a career in finance won't regret in their career throughout their life, because it is growing.
Yeah, I mean, finance is all about money, and that is the basic requirement for any kind of economy or any kind of operation or growth. So this sector will never die. This sector will always have something going on.
Yes. So Ashish, would you like to share something regarding your app, Receiptree?
Yeah, so I started this app in 2020. It's a free for all app. It's live right now. The app itself digitizes paper receipts. So when you go to a point of sale to the checkout, when you take a paper receipt, you've got lots of important items in it that you would want to diarize or remember. Because they could come with a guarantee or warranty. 90% of the times, those receipts do not have the guarantee warranty information. They usually come in as a supplement paper.
Really, yes.
Yeah. So what this was the idea behind this app, is to be able to digitize and diarize that information and easily retrievable in a one centralized location. So when you go take a picture of a receipt, our ML AI engine automatically digitizes it. So the retailer's name, the product, list of products, line items with the currency, the amount, and it gives you the option to select specific products which have a warranty or guarantee information on it.
Oh,
so
wow.
You could diarize those information with a thumbnail of the receipt. So should you say, for example, you bought a washing machine and it has a 2-year warranty on it. If something goes wrong, usually you end up losing the receipt or you forget where you got the washing machine from, or your retailer tells you they need a proof of purchase which you don't have anymore. So to avoid this kind of stress, you could just quickly go into the app, look for washing machine in our app. It will give you the list with the washing machine and the photograph of the receipt. This is all they need as a retailer to show to them, this is the date I purchased it, this is the authentication on the receipt, and they can look at the purchase and save you that hassle or that argument with that retailer. And you can make the most of your purchases or your money, especially in today's world where everybody is struggling.
Exactly, it yes. Is,
yeah,
it is a must for Generation Z and millennials like us. It is a must exactly. App.
Exactly. And the next step, what we are doing right now, we're speaking with a few retailers.
Uh-huh.
Our aim is to plug in our app directly onto their front-end systems. So basically say goodbye to paper receipts completely. The moment you put in your mobile number onto the point of sale system, the receipt comes electronically with all the information automatically on there. So you don't have to log or file your purchases again.
So is it just in UK or have you launched this app in India as well?
No. It's launched globally. So we've users all over the world, all the way from US to Maldives or to Mauritius or India, everywhere.
Oh, wow. So what I'll do is I will add the link of your app in the description of this video. Okay.
Thank you.
So lastly, one line of motivation for the students who are pursuing management in finance.
Focus on yourself first. Don't jump into getting a job straight away, because this is the mistake I did, and I'm talking from my personal experience. It's okay to wait a month more to get the right job, because once you are into a role, then it is very difficult to for the first 2 years to get that boost unless you're in the role that you actually like. If you actually like what you're doing, you will be able to do justice to the role and give that 110% that is needed to get that faster acceleration. So in terms of finance, it's a very large area. Know your capabilities. If you're good with numbers, then look at roles accordingly. If you're good with client services, look for roles accordingly. If you want to do something in middle office, then look for roles accordingly. But first, look within that. Where do you see yourself, not today or tomorrow, but for the next 3 years? And accordingly, look for a role that will fit you better. If that role is not out there, then try and look for the next best solution rather than just jump on something that might not do justice to yourself.
Exactly. That would motivate all of us, all of the Generation Z and millennials, all the upcoming grads. So thank you so much, Ashish, for taking out time and giving this interview. I'm so grateful to interview with you.
Thank you for having me. I really appreciate
Thank you so much, Ashish. We'll see you soon.
See you. Good luck to everybody.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Take care.
Bye. Take care. Bye.